pray that God will bless your family in the mighty name of Jesus. That at the end of this meeting, you'll be glad you are here and that you have been blessed. Thank you, our Father. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Amen. Father, thank you for this morning. Thank you for this church. Thank you for the pastor. Thank you for the members. Thank you for the ministers. Thank you for our daddy, our national elder that is here. We say, blessed be your name in Jesus' name. Thank you for all of our lives. Thank you most importantly for the choir. And thank you for the two women you have sent to bless us this morning. Lord, again, you have been speaking to us. Speak to us one more time in Jesus' mighty name. By the time we're going home, we'll be glad we came. Thank you, our Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. As I was growing up as a believer, we are taught that when you are praying and rain starts falling, or a good visitor now, come visit you, it might mean God has answered your prayer. So that our daddy walking this morning is a sign that God has answered our prayers and that this meeting is blessed already in Jesus' name. Amen. So that once again, you are welcome, sir. We are glad to have you around. So, essential ingredient for happy family. At least, if you don't know anything at all, as women in particular, we know what are ingredients. Ingredients are things that you put in the food or whatever you are doing to make it what you want it to be. Is that correct? For example, if you are in a ceremony where they use cake, they will call the person that do the cake, say maybe a birthday ceremony. Say, and the person is saying, in this cake, we put this, we put that, we put this, and we put that. And when you eat the cake is sweet. Say, this person is good. And next time you want to make a cake, you want to call the person to come and help you make a cake because the ingredients that you use are correct. But it's not the ingredient alone that sometimes matters, but your ability to blend them together. For example, if you say, you call this two mommy, for example, mommy, can you just stand up? Mommy, can you stand up? God bless you. They say, mommy, you give this mommy, maybe I buy something worth 10,000 naira. Tomato, onions, pepper, maggi, and I give the two of them the same quantity of soup material, stew material, for example, and the same quantity of meat. And I say, mommy, please cook stew for me. Mommy, cook stew for me, the same thing, same quantity. The output or the eventual result, what mommy will bring, and what this mommy will bring, can they taste the same way? Answer, please. What's different? The ability of individual to blend the materials together. Am I making sense now? God bless you, please sit down. So therefore, when you say essential ingredient of a happy home, it means that ingredient you have, I may likely have it. The ingredient I have, you may likely have it. But the ability of that ingredient to work perfectly for you or well for me depend on my ability or your own ability to mix them together in perfect union. I saw that say, Ile ti Jesun bangbe, ile ayoni, ile ayoni. If you know the song, please join me. Ile ayoni, ile ti Jesun bangbe, ile ayoni. Sing it one more time. Number one, and the most important of all the ingredients in a happy Christian home. Everything I've been talking this morning is, I'll be assuming we are all Christian families. Is that okay? And I believe you are all Christian family. Am I right? If you know that Jesus is your family, can I see your hands up? Amen. That means I'm talking to the right people. So that's our ingredient number one. Jesus in our family. Then I'll be also discussing some other ingredients. There are about five of them. If I can finish, good. If I can't finish, it's only one or two I can treat. At least you are blessed. And that time, if you have the opportunity, we do it again. Please start talking. If you have questions, be writing it down or you ask later. Excuse me. Now, despite the fact that Jesus is in our family, we pray every morning or in the evening, as the case may be. Husband pray, wife pray. We come to church, we pray to Jesus. Despite that, we see some little troubles in our homes. Is that correct?
Yes.
Despite the fact that ingredient number one, the most important of it, Jesus, is in our homes. And other things I was discussing this morning. But our ability to blend those ingredients together makes our family a happy home. The disciples were on the water and there was trouble. They tried all they could, but they couldn't help. And they remember there is a man underneath the boat, inside the boat. It's a big boat, inside the boat, there's a room there. And they said, Jesus, don't you care, we perish? And he asked them, where is your faith? And eventually he said, peace be still. And they were wondering, what kind of a man is this? That even the water and the wave, they obey him. Now, your ability and my ability to allow that Jesus to interfere in our affairs, our family, make a lot of difference. Amen? So, all the ingredients I've been talking this morning, it's not new, it's not strange. But your ability to mix them perfectly in your home makes a difference. So, I'll be discussing two primary ingredients and three semi-primary ingredients in our Christian home. And if you're not married, I say you are welcome because you are most blessed. You will learn and be better than those of us that are married. Some of us will be married and we learn with experience. Thank God it's working out for us, but some are not as lucky as that. Some they are learning, but learning is in a bad way. May that not be our experience in Jesus' name. Like a woman was talking the first time, was talking of abuse in the family. They are learning too, but in a bad way. That will not be our house in Jesus' mighty name. Amos 3, verse 3. Amos 3, verse 3. Amos 3, verse 3. I want to read directly from the scripture itself. I know you know it, but I want to read from there. It says, can two walk together except they be agreed? Except they be agreed. If your Bible is like my own, you will discover that the agreed here is in the past tense. It means if I want to go to Lagos and I say, Mommy, I want to, are you following me to Lagos? And she said, ah, we are going to Lagos. That means we must have agreed before we leave Badon to Lagos. Am I making sense? But if I just hijack on the road and say, I'm going to Lagos, and our intention is to go to Kaduna or Kano, can we agree on the way? No. And many marriages are like that. As a matter of fact, 90% of marriages never have any form of agreement or agreement in basic areas before they embark on that journey. And now, after marriage, they discover that my purpose and my journey in life is different from my wife's own. Otherwise, you say, my purpose and my journey in life is different from my husband's own. And therefore, they will never be agreed unless they sit and sit down again and they agree to be agreed. Amen? And that's how it is in many homes. But where that is, this morning, God will start putting corrections in our families and heal those homes in Jesus' mighty name. So if you are not married, you are better. You can call yourself for that now and avoid this pitfall, which many marriages are. Many marriages are in that pitfall. They are struggling to correct it. But if you are married and you discover that your home is like that, the wisdom to correct it and to manage it well and to end up being fine for the glory of God and the benefit of your children and to your own head, God will give you that wisdom in Jesus' name. Because if the family is good and the family is happy, the possibility of you not falling sick is high. The possibility of you not having all these ailments is high. Even the ailment is in your body, it will not be able to overcome you and put you down because you are always happy. Once your emotion is happy, you are emotionally balanced, there is hardly any sickness that can have a place in your body. But when you are emotionally down, the Bible says a rotting bone is the ailment of the flesh. When your heart is heavy, there's possibility that sickness has a place in your body. So essential number one is our connectivity or agreement in spiritual matter. And I want to start with this because it's very important. Connectivity or agreement in spiritual matter, or I call it commonality in spiritual matter. Many of us don't know that is a basic ingredient that is missing in our home, and that's why we always have issues. Now, for the youth, please listen, and for the married, please listen as well. If you want to have a happy home, work towards having common ground in faith, common ground in belief, common ground in church you attend. For example, you cannot be a member of this parish, Precious Seed Parish, here, and your husband is a member of Love Arena Parish, still the same redeem. Even though you are still close, as it were, but under certain conditions, it may have some rough edges in your marriage. How much less if you are a member of Anglican and your husband is a member of say Methodist, there is no way you don't have problem. For example, now, my mommy taught us this morning, that mommy taught us this morning. Now, me, I'm doing my own now. Let's say your wife is hearing all this thing. I'm here with my wife now. All that I hear this morning, she have heard them. Abby, if I get to myself, that thing that mommy said, can we apply it? Because she heard it, it wasn't my idea. I heard it from that place. It'd be easy for her to buy that idea. Am I making sense, please?
Yes.
But if I heard it and she didn't hear it, she may likely argue with it. She may ask questions, which I may not be able to answer. And even if I'm answer, you say, oh, calm down because you are selfish. Oh, calm down, I do not mean. Because it's your own end. You're always happy about your own self. So please, that is very, very important. Don't attend church in Kano and your husband is attending church in Abuja. It may have some slight effect on your marriage if you don't manage it very well. So that is very important. The frequency of attendance in church also matter. If you are a woman, you want to be attending Tuesday, Thursday, Sunday fellowship, and you marry a man that wants to be attending only on Sunday, you will have problem. There is no way you will not have problem. There is no way you will not have problem. So these are basic things that affect our spiritual matter. When I say spiritual matter, not just now, I know you might be thinking about maybe husband is holy, wife is not holy. It's far from that. Put that one by the side first. You are coming there. But even in these other areas, attending churches, attendance in church, the two must agree on that. If you are not married, please hear this. You must agree on that before you marry. Or else, there will be a problem. Go and ask those that are in need. They will explain to you. You must agree on the involvement of your children in your faith. Let me give an example. For example, now, my wife is not using earring. And me too, I don't like women that use earring. I'm not saying it's not good. Don't misquote me. Because if you are misquoting me, you will not even be benefiting what I'm teaching. So listen to my message and not pick my fault. And now we now have a daughter. I don't like it. And I love her not using it. Is that okay? But inside of her heart, she wants to use it. I'm not my wife now, I'm just saying as a husband now. She wants to use it. But she's not using it because my husband or our church said we should not use it. And now we now have a daughter. And one day I went out in the morning, maybe in the first 8 days of that young girl's life, and I came back in the evening, and I see my guest here already having small tea inside. Do you think I'll be happy? You're not answering. I will never trust that woman all my life again. Because there and then I know that she only doing what she's doing, not because she's convinced, but because she's trying just to follow along. I will not trust her again in any spiritual matter. So before you marry her at all, agree on that. And that is the problem of many Christians. Here we is a man. He doesn't like women. They like the wife doesn't. The wife doesn't. The wife is dressing like my sister here. But anytime you see a woman that wear trousers and paint her face, paint her lips, she's happy with that one. Inside of his heart, he's interested in that girl. He loves that girl's appearance. But he cannot tell the wife not to be dressing like that because the woman will not agree. This is her life right from day one. Are you following me? That man will never be at peace with that woman as long as they are together because they never agreed on dressing. So if you want show your woman that's always loud in her dressing, don't go for a simple one like this, my sister. You will never agree. And if you want a simple one like this, and you go and marry the one that's always loud, ask someone, buy Moshirim, but don't fail me. This hour has always been, don't you see me? Why do you want to change me overnight to that other sister like that? That you what? And this is the basis of our problems in many of our families. So agreement in spiritual matters makes a lot of difference. There are women, a woman was talking to me sometime, he said, I started dressing like this because it's what my husband wants. And I told her that has that changed who he is? Not change. Amen. So agreement in all these spiritual things must be very, very important. Agree in your dressing, in your cultural or traditional practices. Agreed on it. Please, wear this thing and nothing. You may sometimes you don't know why a man loses interest in a woman. Or vice versa. If we get there too, if God help us, if time allow us. Sometimes you saw that this man loves you before you marry. It calls you all kinds of names. And vice versa. And suddenly after marriage, the man just loses interest. Or the man just loses interest. I've been wondering what is the problem. Some of this thing I'm talking about might be and has always been the problem. Because you may love the person. You may like the person. But because you never agree on this other area, you begin to dislike him or her before you know it. So have common ground in dressing, in cultural belief. For example, there are homes where in the first 8 days of getting a baby, they must take the baby to their grandpa in the village. At the Bimo, only lay you. And here you are, your own family, you don't do that. And you never agree with your husband or your spouse or your wife that in my own household, this is how we are going to be doing our own. If you start doing it, the woman may not be happy or the man may not be happy. Take for example, as a believer, I don't believe in any of these cultural things, village things. There are believers that believe in them. They are believers all the same, but they believe in them. Now, you are a woman, you believe in those things, and the first 8 days of your child's life, you perform some ritual on him. Because that's what you do in your family, and your mama is an aunt, or your wife is an aunt, and they do it for that child. And your husband or your wife get to know, and he doesn't believe in it. And he get to know that you did that for his child or for her child. You can be sure there will be a problem in that house. Am I communicating, please? So your ability to mend all these areas make a lot in making our home what it's supposed to be. Church support and spendings. You must agree on that as well. If you are a woman, you love giving to God, you but marry a man that his hand is gone to money. Each time you give to God, and the man get to know about it, there'll be a problem. So you must know and agree on this. The influence of religions, on celebrations, on birthdays, on anniversaries, on parties, on things you do. There are birthday parties. As a woman, maybe you are a conservative type. You don't want your child to attend. And as a man, you don't care. You can attend any birthday parties. That may be a source of conflict in your home. You might think it is small. Please listen. You might think it is small, but they have a great image on a great impact on your relationship. You might never know that's the reason why you are never agreeing on many things, because you are eroding your trust without you knowing it. There are songs. This man doesn't like all these worldly songs, but you don't care. You don't care. Your children, you don't care. You do all these things. It might affect your relationship. It might even be shy reasons. all these other areas are the things that we must consider. 1 Corinthians 1 verse 10. Please help me read that. 1 Corinthians 1 verse 10. If you are there, let me read it. 1 Corinthians 1 verse 10. 1 Corinthians 1 verse 10. Sorry, I will be reading directly from here, but can I access my Bible readily? 1 Corinthians 1 verse 10. Please fast read that if you are there. Wait, ma'am. He said, I beseech you, brethren, by the Lord Jesus Christ, that you speak the same thing. And there be no division among you. That you speak the same thing. That's okay, ma'am. And there be no division among you. Philippians 3:16. That you speak the same thing, and there be no division among you. If you don't speak the same language as husband and wife, surely there will be division. Let us walk by the same rules. Let us mind the same thing. A family that doesn't walk by the same rule, they don't mind the same thing, they will hardly be free of conflict. The wife is going to Tuesday Bible study, husband don't attend. The wife is going by 7 a.m., husband will not come until 10 a.m. They are minding the same thing, they are not walking by the same rule. Let us mind the same thing. Let us walk by the same rules. You may think it doesn't have effect on you, but it's having a grave impact on your family. Before you know it, you will be distancing yourself small from each other. That closeness will not be there. I pray that this is a prevailing. Heaven will have mercy and help us to solve this problem in Jesus' mighty name. If you're not married, please don't fall to that before. Oh, don't fall to that before. And if you are married, please see how you can work it out with prayer and with grace. Number two, what's the first thing I said? What was the first thing that makes our marriage, the first ingredient in our marriage? Apart from Jesus Christ, what was the first? I said the most important is Jesus Christ. Now there are two. Community or agreement is spiritual matter. That's the first ingredient. Please don't forget it. Don't forget it. Agreement in spiritual matter. Let us mind the same thing. Let us walk by the same rule. Philippians 3:16. If you don't mind the same thing, there is no way you will not have problem. Mommy is so different. Maybe thank God for online now. There are many programs online. I do myself one time. Mommy is always, mommy having online VG, maybe on Wednesday nights. She doesn't miss it. But daddy doesn't care. I can still try. I can still throw out into any. A time will come. Mommy and my daddy will come. Only problem will lay one. So you can't draw back because he doesn't pray. I taught the woman very well. I'm a counselor by God's grace. They will say, I'm the one carrying the body of spirituality in my family. I'm the only one praying. I'm the only one fasting. My husband doesn't join me. And I had met you. I'm the only one praying. I'm the only one fasting. My wife, come on, dear. We shall need it here. In that kind of a house, is there a division there or not? Answer me, please. You're not answering, no. There is. Just mind the same thing. How you will do it, that your husband or your wife will join you in those things, is none left in your hands. And God will give you the wisdom in Jesus' name. Until you agree on those things, there is no VG I attend that my wife doesn't attend unless one of us is sick. There's hardly any church program I attend that she's not there. We must mind the same road. We must mind the same way. Praise the Lord. Number two, and this first one, eventually we have impact on this number two. In one way or the other. And number two, we have impact on number one. Number one, talk about spirituality. Number two is not talking about who we are as human beings. Commonality or agreement in the other room. Let me use that word because of our children here. Commonality or agreement in the other room. The Bible says you should mind the same thing, you should agree on the same thing. Ingredient of a happy home. Even if Jesus, physically speaking now, become a tenant in your house. Are we together? Hello? or you are even magnanimous enough, say, okay, you are not tenant, you do our call, but I've asked one landlord. You make your landlord. And you're making your landlord, physically speaking, now he's leaving your house as a landlord. If this other area is 40, that house will never have peace. If you like, that the jail is in Ibadan, and you say that we have a room in our house, we decorate the room and sleep in our house, and that is sleep in your house, because it's a man of God and he brings peace, maybe for 3 months, I never ran here because of the jail was in the jail. But after 3 months, I might resume back to where you stopped before the GO came. If this area is at fault, and please let me tell you the truth, in many Christian homes, their other room is dead. In many Christian homes, the mommy was saying at that time, he said many of our quarrels in our houses are related to these areas. I've heard of families for the past 10 years, they've not slept together, and they're in the same house. Somebody was talking at that time and said, for the past 3 years, I don't know the color of the part of my wife. That kind of a house, there is no way you will have peace. You cannot have peace. So once you don't agree, and the problem we have in many of our homes, as young men and women, please listen carefully. Before you marry, many of us don't do it because you don't know. Before you marry, sit yourself down. Already I was casting a couple, I asked them, I was talking to them about this subject, and they were laughing. I was looking at them. Before you marry, sit yourself down. This thing, me, I like him. What about you? There's no sin in discussing it. Is it the doing that is sin? But in discussing, there's no sin. We shy away from it before we marry. Even in marriage, many people are just shying away from it, and they are paying heavily for it. Hello? So this other side too, you must agree to have it as regular and as possible. Now, you will ask the question, why is it that we are in love to each other, and yet we don't make love? Or you just do it once in a while? Number one reason is why, under the cinema too, number one reason why this area is scarce in our home is the sometime availability or unavailability of finance. Proverbs 30 verse 7 to 9 says, God bless me with money. Proverbs 30 verse 7 to 9 says, bless me with money so that I will not steal. And don't bless me too much to the point that we need to ask God, who is God? So availability or non-availability of finance is the reason why many Christian couples are not making love. And it ought not to be. Rather, there was somebody there was in the counseling, the woman said, he said, it will take God's grace for a woman to open up to a man that is not giving her money, even the husband. That's why you see them on the streets. The easiest thing in the street now is that commodity. If you have the money, you can carry anyone on the street. Amen? So please, money will come by God's grace. When we are very small, we are told that when you marry, things somehow improve on your marriage. And things are not good before begin to be good. Is that okay? But these days, it's really like that. Because before, when a woman gets to a man's house, they are united in thought, in purpose, in mind. And they make love freely as husband and wife. But today you see a place where the man, if he's not happy, if he's not having money, himself is not happy. And the wife that's not giving money to herself is not happy. And two unhappy people in the house cannot make love. Somehow, and God of that, before you know it, they are in the same house, but they are far apart. And we are such a God will heal our home in Jesus' mighty name. Some women begin to hate their husband, dislike him, because he's not bringing impressively. Just notice the day the money comes in, she's happy and she's joyous. And the day the money is not coming in, she's the other way around. And the same thing, the man too. The way things are going well, he's happy. Don't allow money to control your love life. Because the day you met yourself, you didn't say, if God bless us with money, we'll be husband and wife. But there's no money, we will not be husband and wife. Is that how you agree? Hello? Is that the agreement? No. So, unavailability of finance might be a problem. And that, you must work on it. Then, number two, abundance or loss of affections. Loss of affections or the abundance of affections. The more you love your wife or your spouse or your husband, the more you want to intimate with him or her. The less you love, the less you want to be intimate. And I must tell you the truth. It is possible to love before marriage and stop loving after marriage. It happened in many homes. Many have divorced just because of that. And many, though they don't divorce, but they are suffering in silence. And we are believers, we can't live ourselves. But at the same time, they are not making love. And I tell you the truth, in a home where that area is missing, or is lacking, or is dragging, it will be difficult for them to have the kind of peace or happy home we are talking about. So, and what is the reason why there is loss of affection? What are the reasons for loss of affection? It might be because, number one, loss of virtues. Loss of virtues. That the Bible called, the Yoruba call it Iwa. In Peter, 2 Peter 1 verse 5, 2 Peter 1 verse 5, it says, add to your faith virtue. Efi Iwa kun igbagbo. Efi kini o? Iwa kun igbagbo. Add to your faith virtue. If you are virtueless, you behave anyhow, you don't have good behavior, no man or woman will be attracted to you, even your own wife too, or your own husband. So we see this man doesn't like coming to you. Ask yourself, what is the reason? What is the reason? Or this woman doesn't like coming to you. What is the reason? Maybe your virtue is bad. So look at your virtues. And virtues sometimes also affect our mouths. The Bible says, let your word be seasoned with grace. In Colossians 4 verse 6. Colossians 4 verse 6. If your word is bad, I was talking to a woman of late. She said, how can a man talk to me anyhow? And I'm sure you are winning. You were ordained. And what the man who was believing, not come out of me, didn't know it. A man that talk to his wife like that during the day, and the night trying to rob himself to him, will the woman agree? No. Never. So, and if you do that consistently, it will get to a point the woman will lose sexual interest in you. And the same thing for the man. You don't dress well, you don't dress in it, you are even smelling to him. He may not tell you, but he'll be drawing away from you small, small. And before you know, it's losing sexual interest in you. It is possible for a man or a woman to lose sexual interest in the partner. Go and read Deuteronomy 24, 1 to 4. Deuteronomy 24, 1 to 4. And that's why David and Moses gave them the grace or the permission to divorce. Deuteronomy 24, 1 to 4. So don't allow that to happen by the use of your tongue or by your behavior. And I tell you, only few women have good virtues. The same thing, men. Only few. So if that is you, you may be losing interest in your partner. And that time is the quality of time you spend together. Quality of time you spend together. Now let me say something on this. Ingredient of a happy home. I've told you, if lovemaking is rare or is scarce, aside medical conditions, maybe there is sickness, the man has issue, or the woman has issue, is a different thing. Aside that, there's nothing that stops us from making love as regular as possible. But lovemaking is not in the thing itself. You understand me, Abi? Hello? Am I communicating? It's not only in that, it's also in your spending time together. Quality time, touching one another, playing with one another. The woman putting her head on the man's chest. At times you put your head on the woman's leg. Not that you're watching TV, Mommy is sitting in the north, daddy is sitting in the south. And you say, ah, I want to talk to you, I want to kiss that I want. Hello? Instead of you to see, maybe you are watching a film. Like of late, my wife was watching a film, and was saying, ah, this lady, and she's married in real life, oh, why is she kissing somebody like this in the film? Ah, the husband try, oh. Especially as a man and a woman watching that kind of film, when you see that, what you're supposed to do, go and meet your husband and do your own too. That's supposed to be, but in many of our homes, I come out, we're not in that way, we're not parity. The man may not talk, the woman may not talk, but her mind or his mind is drawing away from you small, small. In content, I want to tell you money, to one sheta, want to one little cliche. Samson was good to Delilah every now and then. Four good times. This lady was asking Samson, where is your strength? Tell me. Are they fake careful? Are they performing to suffer no chojue? And they want to kill him, he will escape. Four good times. Samson knew that Delilah will kill him. And yet he was going there. You ask me why? And it's happened many of our home like that. He was going there because the man was giving him what he wanted. He find comfort in that girl. May your husband not find comfort in another woman. No? Yeah. Women, men are like boys. If you want to catch the heart of any boy, they give him biscuits. Anytime you come and buy biscuits. And my children, they know me. Once they see me, they say, Daddy. That the uncle, they know more. Biscuit, don't get back. And as soon as I give them the biscuit like this, they will walk away to their parents. There's a boy in every man. And there's a girl in every woman. We come there shortly. So these ladies outside, they know how to touch the boy. Don't touch the man. As long as you are touching the man, you will never win his heart. Go for the boy in him. What do I say? Go for the boy in him. And the boy in him is seeking for comfort. Samson was finding comfort. When each time he get there, you know where he always put his head? On Delilah's lap. Are there sulo? Bento mo wine? Only sugar? To the point that you are cutting his head and was dozing. You know, it's a mighty man. Imagine a man that only one man killed 1,000 Philistines. With a not even with a sword, with a jaw of an ass, donkey. The ordinary jaw of an ass. Go and try, my brother, to see how many you will kill. Only one man. After such a battle, that man need comfort. But I was talking to a pastor. The pastor was, may God help our pastor. Many pastors are lamenting you. Many ministers are lamenting me. Come on, lay for bringing on cool left. At the same time, no one will do because they lack comfort. The man that fought such a mighty war, after that battle, he needs a place where he can put his head and sleep without anybody disturbing him. And Delilah was the only one providing that comfort for him. You think he will not go there? Even though you know he will die, he will still go there. And that's why I go and read that Bible very well, that passage very well. Start from 16 of Judges. Samson never blamed Delilah. He never blamed him here for what she did. Because he knew that this lady was my comfort, either in life or in death. He never for one day blamed Delilah. Amen. I'm blaming Delilah. So the man will always go there, because there's a comfort that was. When he called, and you are working this morning, why are you like this? Okay, what do I do for you now? But you, as soon as it's coming, Tiranti Ra Petro Waloni, and for Jenabi, Kotiki, Kotiki, as soon as it's coming like this, Daddy Jem, Loni again, Dara Simi, if you see what Dara Simi did today, Kotiki, and if you go to a place where they will not bombard him with any of those trouble, I can also, I got down here, the Wale. And you say you don't go there, it will take grace, it will take gift of God. And the same thing for the woman. Here is a woman that needs to be pampered. If you see any woman that have affection outside her marriage, all she's looking for is pampering. As a girl in every woman wants to be pampered. And men, including myself, can be very guilty in this aspect. Every woman wants to be pampered. Men, please learn to pamper your wife. Say good words to her. If she's doing something nice to you, tell her how good she is, how she has been of comfort to you. She will do more. So go for the girl in her and not the woman she is. The woman she is 40. She's beautiful, but she's dirty. She's beautiful, but she cannot keep the house tidy. She's beautiful, but she even sleep out in the wahala. That's the woman she is. But go for the girl in her and touch that girl. She will become the woman you want her to be. Am I hearing something? But we are all this are not. We are all this are not. It will affect our intimate relationship. And once our intimate relationship is affected, then there will be problem in the house. I beg of if I ask us now, that for the past, maybe the married one among us, first of all, for the past 2 weeks, how many times do you make love? You will hear one, you will hear nothing at all, you will hear two. May God heal our home in Jesus' name. God will heal our family in the mighty name of Jesus. Say a good amen. Don't worry, listen, you hear me, I'm almost standing up. So avoid that pitfall. Quality of time together makes a lot of difference. And quality of time simply means we spend time together, not even in doing that thing. There should be time you put your head, even if it's not coming to you, go to him and put his head on your lap and be playing with it. He enjoy it. And the same for the man too. Hello? Please, let us try it. Next time, try it again. Because you have a goal. Your goal is to keep your family. And don't let your family to get to the hand of strangers out there. And I pray, and it's just like a woman, if a woman find a man that is more caring, more loving, everybody want to be pampered. To be pampered doesn't have to be money. Sometimes we think it's money. It has nothing to do with money. Money can help, but it's not money. It's a habit we learn. It's a habit we must learn. Love making and pampering each other and taking care of each other is an art. An art is a learned behavior. None of us here came from heaven and know how to make love from heaven. We learn it on heart. So it's we must learn to do it. And the more you learn, the better we are. And that's what all those outside there are doing. And to destroy family. May our family not be destroyed in Jesus' mighty name. So the third thing, those are the two primary things that may affect our home. And your ability to mix this together, your spiritual life and your love life. The last meeting we have, I was telling people there, I said, it seemed to me that the more spiritual couples are, the less they make love. Have you noticed that? And it's wrong. It's not the mind of God. Because we are not angels. We are human beings. We are spiritual, but we are human beings. So don't allow your spirituality to affect your love life. And that's why you must blend the two together. I told you that this ingredient is in all our homes. But our ability to blend them together makes a lot of difference. The fissure my wife has, this mommy have it, Abby? Are we together, please? The fissure my wife has, this mommy have it. But the joy in her family and the joy in my family depend on how she can miss her own, depend on how me and my wife can miss our home. Am I making sense now? That's what makes a Christian home. If you don't have it, some men are complaining, they are their wife, OVT every day, fasting every day, don't take care of you, don't have time for daddy. Are all wrong you? So these are the two primary ones. Now the secondary ones that you must also take note that can affect these other two is number one, quality of parenting. quality of parenting. Now, before you marry, for your marriage, the married one, ati wono, ati wono both, you know, Allah come about to share loku. Say amen.
Amen.
But your marriage, please, before you marry, agree with your spouse. How many children love any? Before I marry me, at least at that one, not me and my wife, we did that one. How many children love any? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Ah, me, I love children, I must have it. And you agree. And I now get to the place and said, this two is okay. And I didn't care. Me, I love children, though. My mother have 8. And me, I must have 10. Agree on that. And if you are not agree, it is not too late to agree. Amen? Because only the living can take care of children. It's not too late to agree. So agree on that. Now, the quality, that one, the number of children. It might also talk about the sexes. I agree with my wife that this number of children we have, if they are all male, to God be the glory. If they are all female, to God be the glory. Nothing have to do with it. I must have my type. I can't be the only one in this house. Hello? Am I communicating, please? Agree on that. But this, I don't care why be or more. Agreed on the quality of parenting. Mom was talking the other time about children. Don't give your phone to your children. Many of our mothers are guilty of this. And fathers too. Children of today, they are over smart. The other day, my wife gave our boy the phone. And after working with me, they sent an assignment from their school. After working with the phone, and he turned the phone back to her. The following morning, when he woke up, he saw some text on the WhatsApp. When the phone was with him, all things chatted with me. And that one, another girl in his class. The following, their last messages in here, they reply, see, to the phone, and in the phone, to reply, oh, I will listen, I will learn. Assuming we didn't see that last one, we will know that you are shattered. We will never know that shattered. So don't ever trust your children with your phone. Any mother or father that trusts his or her children with her phone is a bad mother. Ah, my child is a choir member. Ah, my child is a godly child. Matter, right? The woman that at 10 years old was misbehaving. She said the girl went to Dubai as a virgin. Is that one a virgin? But that's the thought the mother have about her. 10 years old, having 502 videos online. How much it got to here a long time ago. So that quality of a parenting, that's what I'm going to do. That's what I'm just by the side. Quality of parenting. Any house that have bad of children that are not well brought up, there is no way we enjoy your marriage. Not you, my mother. God bless you in Jesus' name. Ada ni mommy, iwo lo fa. Iwo lo ko won. Ada ni mommy ani pe aradi eyin na le fa. Eyin ni won jo. I man blame around be yen. And because of that, they will never have peace in their home. You can't have bad children and you expect your husband to be sleeping with you happily or to be fellowshipping with you happily and vice versa. And it begins with small corrections. That is, why do you put this book here? There and there, money, I'm too, I know that. Go bad, no. What about your money in jail? So the quality of parenting matters. And please, young one, agree with whoever you are marrying before you marry. How many children? The sexes, if they are all boys and all girls, and God give us, we agree. But more importantly, the quality of parenting. Many Christians are sleeping parenting wise. They are prayer warriors, they are church people, but their children are not following their steps at all. One, because they're not training the children well. Number two, I won't go for one. Because I won't share one, one. And our children are watching us. The day you insult daddy, do you know that if mommy and daddy are making love, our children knows? You think they don't know? They know. And how do they know? Your behavior, your cordial behavior. If there's some cordiality, if there's no investment in quality time together, the children knows. They know daddy and mommy don't really love themselves because they don't spend time together. If you love your wife, you can't hide it from your children. And the same thing for a woman. If you love your husband, you truly love that man, you can't hide it from the children. They know. And if they notice that two of you are not really in love, you are just parents bringing four children, they will never follow your Jesus. Because they know that your Jesus is fake. A Jesus that cannot help your marriage, can he help their life? A Jesus that cannot help your own family. And as a child, wait for me. They may be doing your way as when they are in their house. Let them get to campus. You know you have not done anything in their life. Let not be your children in Jesus' name. So if you love yourself, there is no way your children will not know. And that is this. Children know who is the problem between mommy and daddy. If you like, coach them. As a wife, coach them. As a husband, coach them. Talk evil about your wife as a father. Or wife, talk evil about your man as a mother to the children. But they know who is the problem. And one day when they are old enough, they will tell you, mommy, I ain't got any problem, daddy. A man was telling me one time, this is a grown man, somebody of my age, even maybe older than me, he's a friend. He said the day they discovered that their dad built another house for another woman, when they discovered it, that their mommy nearly died, but the children, they all agreed that mommy go for and won't need no far. Do you hear that? They discovered that their daddy has built another house for another woman, a complete building. See, one was a barrier. But he built another complete building for another woman outside. The woman discovered it, she almost died. But the children and mother said, one suffer and one. The man was telling me, he said, I suffer our way, our government, we mommy low far. They are her children. You. So the children, they know who is the problem among the two of you. If you like, you deceive them. But they know who, all this way, they know I am the problem. Children knows, you can't deceive it. They may be obeying now, even yourself as a parent, as an adult now. Look at your parents. Who is the problem? Maybe you know it. Are you alone now? I'm paroling. So the same way you know who was the problem between mommy and daddy, your own, that's when your own children too know who is the problem between you and daddy, or between you and mommy. And all this thing have a way of influencing our home. Where these things are not correct. If you like, shout Jesus from now to December, the house will not have peace. Because the ingredients are there, they are not blended together very well. I have been told that by the talk on that with Mr. Gary, Tiko Romora, Anikoko, Ibomi Agbe, Bomi Aro, Bomi Adli, and that's not a good one. Two things quickly before I close. Number three things that also can cause this problem. You can see Proverbs 30, verse 11 and 17 for that one. Proverbs 30, 11 and 17. Number four. You're not giving me time. I'll give myself a learning. 10 minutes more. I will soon end up. God bless you. Thank you, sir. Avoid living in debt. Avoid living in debt. Romans 13, verse 8 say, owe nobody anything. Romans 13, verse 8. Deuteronomy 15, verse 6 say, you will truly lend to nations and not borrow. That in Deuteronomy 28, verse 12 said the same thing. Avoid living in debt. It's not a must. We must carry every and go. It's not a must. You must attend everybody, every party. Patu and Lesha, wallo. Patu and Oweri, wallo. But no, we are party day. You no go. You will set in bad law in my own den too. Tell me what's it. And in all this, God bless you, in all this party and traveling, money is being consumed. Avoid living above your means. Any woman or any man that love living in debt, the spouse will not be happy. An unhappy spouse cannot be intimate with you, except the two of you agree as debtors. That one is possible. There are a couple like that. One marriage when they agree, ni, if I own low and they balay line, if I just see yahoo, the same thing, if I just fuck off, it comes my bambe no. I want you better, oh my need peace in them when they agree to be evil. It's true. They've agreed, so they'll be happy. They won't have any problem. They'll flow together easily. But in the house, if you one is in debt, it's always in debt. The other one doesn't like it, they cannot have it in peace. So if you want to have a debtor, if you want to have a family is a family of debtor, agree on it and be good at it. But if you want to be a Christian home, where anybody be knocking your house, it's even embarrassing. 7 a.m. somebody is knocking your house and say, "Eja deo, muti deo," and your children are there. Is it not embarrassing? Is it not embarrassing? So avoid living in debt. That can affect the happiness in your home. Live within your means. Do what? Live within your means. And don't do things to impress anyone. Don't do things to impress anyone. We have a car, by God's grace, only one car. I was telling my wife just last week, I said, by God's grace, our next project now is to paint the car. Because I've done that very long time ago, but we have other things we are putting money into. But if I'm to be going by people around me that have fine car, I have to paint it since. But we don't live our life to please anybody. We live our life to please ourselves and our God. Is that okay, please? Don't say in our office, everybody's using Jeep. My wife, my children's school, every parent come with cars and with Jeep. Let us change our car. I want me, I'm going to change my own. Ah. If you run with other people's house, you may likely have accidents too. Am I communicating? And that may affect your marriage. So live within your means. And lastly, please have a good will. Have a good will. Have a good will. What in 2 verse 1 say, Oru korere sonjo urat padaka lo, good will. Ecclesiastes 7 verse 1 say the same thing. Ecclesiastes 7 verse 1 say, if you have a good will, a good name is better than riches. And teach your children so. Have a good name. If I come to your street, I don't know your house, and I say, I'm asking for mommy or daddy so and so, somebody in that street will be happy to take me to your house. And I'll say, just go to that place. Me, I can't take you there. Because you are a firebrand, and they know you are such in your street. Have a good name. Have a good will. And teach your children that. If you are a woman that's preserving the name of your husband, doing everything to make sure the name is good, the man will not stop loving you. And the same thing for a man. If you are the type that today he is after you, because obviously you have to go there. Tomorrow, DSS is after you, because last time, one of them will come, only one if you can put him there. The wife may not be happy. And that eventually will affect our family. These ingredients are all in all our homes. But our ability to blend them together makes a vital difference. And I trust the Lord to help your family in Jesus' mighty name. You will not miss it in Jesus' name. Your children will not grow up to hate you in Jesus' mighty name. Your children will not grow up to say, "How I wish I never come through this man or this woman," in the mighty name of Jesus. By reason of your marriage, your children will not hate family. Say a good amen. In Jesus' mighty name. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Yes. Absolutely, sir.